What's up guys, welcome here back to another cracking episode. It's XSwordGamer123 here, releasing the new server SpacedOut, guys. Yes, SpacedOut is, again, risen from the freaking undead, whatever, guys. Welcome back. Oh man, I've been working for the last 2 weeks on my server, guys, and the server is now released, so if you do want to hop along and play on my server, then guys, the IP will be on the screen right now and in the description below, guys. So yeah, and obviously the server store and the website will be in the description below, guys, if you need more help as well with that. But yeah, guys, welcome back to SpacedOut. We're in the new hub that I have made. And this here was like, I made this 2 weeks ago, guys. Not even that, probably 3 weeks ago. I don't know. I just made it a long time ago, and it feels like a really long time ago, just because I've been doing so many other things to just get the server released. And yes, yeah, so I'll give you guys, you know, a little quick glance of how the hub is looking like. So obviously SpacedOut, our theme is all about like space and galaxies and all this. So this, guys, you can probably guess which planet this is. This is meant to be Earth. Now, I tried to go with like a headquarters type of thing on top of a mountain. If you guys can like image this as a type of like, I don't know how to say this, but like safe house or a headquarter on top of like a mountain bit, and it's just going to portals, if you know what I mean. So technically it's going to, this is technically the launch pad, let's just say that. Launch pad to go into every different galaxy, because obviously, you know, we're here, we're astronauts. Well, I mean, if you buy the rank, then you're an astronaut. But in general, you guys are recruits, and you come along with the server, and you're ready to take on our minigame server. So yeah, guys, remember, this server is a minigame server, so it's just not it's not only factions, but I've only been working on factions for the sake of it. But just because I needed to get released something out, guys, and obviously all of the other minigames that I will be releasing will be during the server out, when the server's out. So yeah, this is the hub, guys. We are going to hop along to the faction realm, as you guys can see. So you guys, you could do /MVTP factions or walk through the portal. Either way, it will work. So yeah, just walk through the portal and boom, we're here at the factions hub or the faction spawn. Now, it's not amazing, but I wanted to be like this, guys. I wanted to be so really in like compact the server spawn, really, or for factions. And it's not much so far, but by the time that you guys are actually going to come online on the server, because obviously when I'm recording this, it's pre-recorded, so it's not going to be, not everything is done from the time when you guys come online. So when you come online, this spawn here might be changed. There might be stuff in the sky or what, I don't know, the stuff will be changed. But by the way, guys, so if you see this hologram scattered around the server, every time it says mission control in brackets like that, guys, that will be a little bit of a tip to help you guys out. So they're literally everywhere. So we've got the kits, we've got like just a server store, the help menu, you've got the warps, you've got everything here, and we've got this beautiful thing over here, which we will get into later in the video, guys. But yeah, so that is that. On the, what's it called, on the side here, there will be like signs of every like update that's coming up and all that. So if you guys want to know which updates are coming out, there will be signs telling you which, or giving you a little of a hint of what's coming up. So yeah, that's that. So that's cool. Now, guys, I'm going to get into all of the ranks and everything that are on the server at the moment. If you guys do slash buy, click in the factions rank section, there is a couple of ranks. There's 7 ranks out, guys. The first one is Member Plus. Well, the actual first one is the default rank, which is Member, so that's what everybody gets. So when you join for the first time, then we've got the faction rank. So we've got the Member Plus rank, the Pilot rank, the Engineer, the Scientist, the Commander, the Astrophysicist, and the Astronaut, guys. So the top rank is $17.5, which ain't too much. I believe that in pounds is around 15 to 14 pounds. Now, I might be wrong there, but it's around that area. I'm just trying to guess, trying to remember. But those are all of the ranks, guys. Now, obviously, all ranks will be giving you some certain kits. I'm just going to go through. You guys won't be able to see this in the, well, you guys will be, but it will be a little bit too tiny for you guys to actually see. If you guys got good vision, then GG. But we've got some few kits. Everybody gets the kit weekly, daily, and monthly. I'm just going to give you a hint of what kit monthly gives you, because obviously you can do this every month, and it'll only be probably like, I don't know how many months in this map, but a few. But that's the kit monthly, so you get hoppers and all that. Unfortunately, creeper eggs are going to be very rare. Now, creeper eggs, the only way you can get them is from the mystery vault and from shop at the moment. That's the only way you can guys get creep eggs. I will be adding more crates very soon for you guys to receive creep eggs, because I feel like we should be able to, like, creep egg in raiding should be like very hard to do, so you guys will have to buy creep eggs to actually creep egg raid. We've got other like ranks. We've got member plus rank, we've got the pilot kit, and then we've got the engineer kit. And then it goes to build E, which is build engineer, scientist, build scientist, commander. Then you guys get the pattern. But I believe astrophysicist gets a kit base A for physicist. So that's just that. And then we've got, I believe, for the astronaut rank, a double A for the astronaut rank base kit. And there's just so many other things, guys. There is a load more things. With kits and all that, but you guys just have a look on the store of, if you're interested to buy any of the ranks, guys, obviously, you feel free to buy any, obviously, you know, it's a store, but if you guys want to actually see, you're going to have to buy them. If you guys just want to see what they receive, you guys can go on the store and just have a look at the description of each rank. It'll show you all of the perks, kits, and anything else that you guys would like to, no. Now, on the server, if we just go to, so we've got the, this is the spawn, guys. If we go to warp shop, the shop didn't, well, it took me 2 days of warp, obviously not 2 days straight, because obviously, you know, I had to go to school and, you know, sleep and eat and all that, so it's 2 days as in a whole collective type of thing. So, this is the shop, guys. Now, you might remember us from last season, the shop. At the moment, it's plain. There is only that side and that side which are in progress. This side here, by the time the server is probably out, this here will be changed. You might not even have access to this area. There's the stairs going down here. This here probably won't be here, I guess. But this is from all last, from last reset. So this down here, there's probably going to be some sort of like reward system thing going down here. I'm not too sure. There is some few things planned, but guys, as the holograms tell you, this is the blocks and spawners section. Obviously, just not blocks and spawners, but those are the two main things. So we've got all of the spawners down here. I'll give you like a brief look at all of the prices of each spawner. There we are. Boom. So there's all of the spawners. We've got a actually before that, I believe the wolf and ocelot spawner are technically worthless to buy, because the only thing you guys, when you grind wolves and ocelots, the only thing you guys will be able to get from them is XP. Now, obviously, it's not like PvP where obviously you can't get any XP from any mob. In this, obviously, XP you can enchant and weather mobs. But I believe from pig and above, you get like all the port troopers and stuff. Obviously, there will be updates coming soon that wolves and ocelots will drop fish and bones and stuff like that. But here's all of the ingots and all that, and all of the essential blocks. I haven't put every single block, but from all of these blocks, you can make technically every other block in the game, or you can find the other blocks. But these are the essential blocks that you guys will be needing, that's for sure. There are other few things here. We've got the bucket, slime blocks. We've got a Never Star, which actually sells for 1 million. So if you get a Never Star from the crate, it sells for 1 million. Bottles of enchanting, so you can buy the one for 1,000. Book and quill. We've got beacon that you can get from the crate. Sells for 100k. And then we've got ender portal frame, 500k. Just a load of essential things there. Those are all of the type of resources. Well, not resources, but, you know, where you store your stuff in, usable stuff. Gapples. Here's the creep egg. 7.5k for one creep egg. So that's where you actually buy creep eggs. I might be upping that price, though. It depends. All of the potions. I want to briefly just go through this. This guy's here. Took me a whole day just this section to do. But these are all of the items, as it says there, or all of the sellable things which will sell for a lot, like, I don't know, blaze powder and blaze rods and all that stuff. We've got all of the enchantments, so you guys will easily you can guys buy an enchant or enchant, depends on the way you want to really do it. A few things there, and then we've got like raiding essential things, so redstone stuff. So that is the warp shop, guys, so far. Now, obviously, again, there will be new updates happening to the shop, but at the moment, that's how it looks like. So if we go to warp crates, this is the crate section, guys. Now, welcome to warp crates. You'll spawn right here, but the crate is actually down here. The reasoning, that's the best crate, but the common crates, like the one that you guys will hopefully be opening and buying a lot of, will be down there. But there's only one crate added so far, and that's that one. By the time the server's out, there will be all crates, though. But I believe that the crate there will be some sort of voting crate or daily crate, let's say. And this one here will be some sort of weekly crate or a rare crate where, obviously, you know, you can open these every week. And then, obviously, during the week, if you go and buy them, you can still open them. So everybody will hopefully be receiving the weekly crate key every week as a default. But you are allowed to still buy these weekly crates during the week, which obviously you probably have opened it. But yeah, that's just I've actually just thought of that right now, so it's not even a plan. But we've got a few, we only got one crate that's actually being worked on, and this is the Galaxy crate. Welcome to the Galaxy crate, guys. There's a little info on top there with the hologram. I really like that. But that's that. And this is, so I'm going to be guys showing you all the rewards and opening a few crates so you guys can have a look. So, obsidian times 576, that is 9 stacks, and 9 stacks of TNT. You guys can have access to fly command, the commander rank, 0.3% chance, 5.5% chance on the fly, 16 gapples, a galaxy set, which I will be showing you what a galaxy set is, guys. Galaxy crate key times 2, so technically a double up. Bedrock times 2, so you can get bedrock times 2. A never star, which I showed you in the shop, guys, sold for a million, so that's a 3% chance. A beacon times 2. Ender portal frame. A million. 2 million. Wither skull. Galaxy pickaxe. Galaxy wand. Galaxy sword. And galaxy boots. Now, the galaxy wand is a knockback 5, a galaxy sword is a sharpness 6, and a galaxy pickaxe is an efficiency 6, and the galaxy boots, I believe, is depth strider 3, protection 4, and breaking 3. So that's all of that. I'm gonna open a few of these crate keys, guys, and I'm just gonna get, like, I'm only gonna probably open 2 of them, so I'm not gonna actually use all 5. But let's just, obviously the server isn't released at the moment, but by the time the video comes out, it will be released. But I'm just gonna show you of what the basic things you get. This is the best crate, guys, remember. So we've got 9 stacks of TNT, okay? Not that bad. The TNT in obby is amazing if you think about it, but it's not the... Oh, hello. Double up. Nearly the double up. But we've got a ton of obsidian. So these are the common stuff, but you guys will be able to see, like, whilst I'm open this, you guys will be seeing what the most common stuff is. Okay, we've got 16 gaffles. Pretty common. Okay, so... What else can we win? Okay, 16 more gapples. So we got 32 gapples. And what are we going to win? And a galaxy set. Now, that's not a full galaxy set. But if I do slash kit galaxy, I believe. That this is the galaxy set, guys. So a full set of prop 4. Tons of just in ores. 5 gaps. Pretty OP pickaxes and all that. But guys, that's all of the crates. Now, I want to go to warp PvP really quickly because, as you guys can see in chat, a supply crate drop has actually about to be dropped. So this is the warp PvP arena, guys. I won't be just going around and showing you everything. You guys will be able to see. But every 30 minutes, there will be a supply drop, which I believe is 96 crates that will be dropping in the warp PvP arena. You guys will have to fight against each other to open these crates. So they're literally insta-open crates. They're technically like crates, technically, it's from warp crates. But they you don't have to have a crate key for it. Look, they just drop. And as you guys saw there, there's like supply crates that have dropped. So 96 of them have been dropped at warp PvP. If I right-click that, it will give me like a few things. Now, there won't be an announcement if you get something OP, like, I don't know, a double up. Well, no, there's a galaxy quickly that you can get from this as well, which is a 1% chance or something like that. But it tells you which players actually opened it. And at the moment, this is what it looks like. So we've got some few surprises in that chest. Now, there is 96 of these crates. So there's so many of these crates. But the War PvP arena is huge. Like, I can't, this doesn't even render. I've only rendered half of the War PvP arena. And most of the things are obby and TNT. Obviously, this is just a test out, but there will be stuff changing to this. But remember, guys, you will be fighting for all of these items. So whilst you get something really good, you might not be able to get it because it might, I don't know, burn the lava or there'll be people fighting for it. But this is all of the crates, really. And that's technically War PvP Arena. And then obviously there's a little bit of a middle right here. And there's tons of crates here. And then, guys, from these crates, you can actually receive creep eggs from this. So if you need creep eggs, then you might want to go to War PvP sometimes. But yeah, these are all of just... The amount of obby and TNT that you get is randomized. So it's, I believe, there's a 60% chance that you're going to get 5 obby and TNT. So it technically is randomized. So that's all that item. So that's War PvP, guys. So if you want to come and fight around, and this is the War PvP arena, we've got a cool planet up there, and I can't really render it, it's so hard to render all of this stuff, but it's huge, but, I mean, it's wonderful. This took me like half a day to do, really, physically. I mean, and then we've got that planet there that freaking took ages to make, man, but technically, it's two moons that have crashed into each other, and that's the planet, and the sun, obviously, isn't it? Or the star, let's say. And so that's how I meant that theme. But yeah, this is the War PvP arena now, guys. That is nearly everything, I believe. I'll just be going through other things. Guys, this episode is going to be very long, so make sure you guys stay tuned for this. But this is definitely the second part of the episode. There's a little bit of more complicated stuff that I'm going through now. Okay, so there will be something, this is a bit of a hint or a little bit of a heads up, guys, coming very soon on the server. Now, souls. Every time you kill someone, you will receive one soul. If you do /souls me, it will show you the amount of souls you have. Now, in future updates, the amount of souls you guys get. So every time, so to open one of the soul wells, you have to have, or souls, let's say, or space souls, whatever it's called, I'm not too sure at the moment, you guys will be able to open one of these, and obviously it's a randomized kit, or a strength perk, or something, I don't know what it can be, you guys, but you guys can suggest what it could be, but it's gonna be like, I don't know, let's just pretend you guys get, or not pretend, let's just imagine you guys open one of these and get a strength 2 for 30 minutes, that's OP, 30 minutes of strength, only in this world. So if you go into a different world, I don't think it will work, but when you get back into this world, or this area, War PvP, you guys will be able to have strength too, and you guys can go to War PvP, so you really want to just use it. So that's what the souls are going to be, or you guys can use the souls to buy crate keys, buy ranks. There will be challenges, so if you get, like, I don't know, 10,000 souls or something like that, you guys will be able to, like, redeem, like, pilot rank. Now, it's not amazing, but it's just by... It's technically getting the rank for free, which means you have to kill 10,000 players at War PvP. Now, I don't know what it's actually going to be, but I'm going to figure out how this is going to work. But if you do /souls me, it shows you the souls. Now, I'm going to go back to spawn, or if I do MVTP factions, because if you do /spawn, it will bring you to the spawn of that. But... This is okay, we're back at spawn. Now, the Mystery Vault. This is actually something that I'm really excited for, because this is what is going... This is technically for the events, and I've got a cool idea, guys, and I've made this idea. So it's a Mystery Vault, guys. Now, you might have seen this on Hypixel and all that. Yes, you have, but I've changed it a little bit, and I've used it in a different way. Now, Mystery Vaults, obviously, if you right-click it, you'll be able to, like, transfer Mystery Vaults to other players. So if you don't want to have one, if you have too many of one, you guys can give to other players, but why would you if you've won it from a freaking event? You don't want to do that. So this is a Mystery Vault, guys. Now, obviously, these Mystery Vaults aren't like Hypixel where you get these every day, you get these every week, or you get this by killing, I don't know, 10,000 players. No, you get this like from an event. So when you win a parkour event, if you win a PvP event, if you win a true or false event, I don't know, any events that I'll be making, guys, very soon, At the end of it, there will be a command block that you have to, like, I don't know, stand on or sign, or you have to, like, I don't know, do something to obviously access the crate that will, or the box that you guys will be given. Now, I'm going to just give him, I'm just going to give myself all four boxes so I can show you guys what so far the rewards you guys can get. These aren't randomized. So if you win, so if you win a parkour event, let's say, you guys will be able to get the four star legendary box, which is the top box. And then there's just others, which depends on what the event manager wants to give you, really. So that really depends on that. But if I do slash MV set XSwordGamer one star one, now I'll be giving myself all stars. So I'll be doing two, if I type in three and four. So there. So there is four different crates. There will be like Halloween crates and Christmas crates that will be coming out. But those aren't going to come out yet because it's not technically Christmas on my server at the moment. But that's that. So if we guys will open by order. So as you guys can see, there's a common mystery box, the rare, the epic, and the legendary mystery box. So let's open the common one let's just have a look what you get given. By the way, if you get given two legendary box, which is rare, when you open it, it will open both legendary boxes at a time. So we have found a common kit. Now you can only receive one kit from the common box, which is the common kit. This is what at the moment what you get. It's not amazing, but you get sharpness 2 sword and breaking 1, a bit of protection, armor and all that, golden apples and stuff like that, and spawn creep egg. Now this kit here, or this box, will be you guys will be receiving this kit if you go to the warp event. So if you go to the warp event, there will be a pressure plate that you have to stand on, and everybody that stands on that pressure plate will be given one of these crates. And I believe only you can only do it once when you pressure on it or something like that. I will figure out a way to do this, guys. But technically, you'll be given this crate key for this box to everybody. That's very complicated, all this stuff, I must admit. But then we can open a rare. So let's have a look what we're going to get for the rare. Cool animation we get, yay. Mystery box, and boom. Okay, so you just get a rare one. So I'm just going to give you a quick glance, and boom, that's that. So I'm just going to open them. They're really just going in order of how the protection and the sharpness. So it's not really OP, but, you know, it's not that bad. But there will be other stuff added to this. So there will be, like, spawners and titles and perks and all that. So that's the epic. And then we can go to the legendary one, which is the one which is the rarest one of all, obviously, the legendary. I might like do different names for this or that, but I don't know at the moment. But yeah, that is the legendary. So you get protection 4, sharpness 4, 4 creep eggs, which are very rare, and yeah, stuff like that. Boom. So that is the mystery vault. So that is literally the mystery vault. So that's what that's going to be. But I think some souls are going to work with the mystery vault. I'm not too sure at the moment. It depends how I want it, and yeah. Now, there are a few things that I want to go through, there will be titles as well that you can buy. If I do slash buy, you guys can buy faction crate keys, and faction extra kits will be coming soon, as it says there. We've got faction titles, faction mystery boxes, and unban. So faction titles, you guys will be able to buy a faction title, sexy, op, bay, Airs, Wrecked, God, Radar, Pimpia, Skills, 360 No Scope, and hashtag Esplit. Now, I just know, I just made up all of these titles. So you guys will be able to have a title, like it says here, OP, in mine. And then we got XSwordGamer123 here, says sexy, which is, okay, well. But that's that. If we do such by a game, yeah, we've got the mystery boxes, so you can guys buy those mystery boxes if you want. And that is literally all of the main things to go through. I'm going to go through some moderate stuff that you guys will, if you're a mod, you want to probably know. We have a new punishment plugin, or a new punishment lore plugin. So I still have to go through this on the website, so obviously when you're a mod, I will give you all of the permissions to do all of this stuff. Okay, and it says the supply crate has now ended. 5 minutes, guys. Doom. Okay, so if you guys do slash punish, the player's name. So let's just say we're going to punish SuperJJ Gamers. So we're going to punish SuperJJ Gamers for hacking. So you guys, if you're a mod, you will have to type in punish SuperJJ Gamers and whatever he's done. So if he was hacking, you ban from hacking. If he was swearing, whatever. So hacking. Now, it comes up with this GUI. You can have a look at his previous report. So if he's ever been banned before, you can have a look. You can warn the player. You can temporarily moot the player. You can temporarily ban the player. Temporary moot, permanent moot and permanent ban. Now, for hacking, you would have to do the permanent ban. Because that's the permanent ban. But if he was swearing in chat, you can warn him. He has 3 warnings. Then it's a temporary moot. If he still does it, it's a, well, you can't really have a temp. You can't have a permanent moot. Do not use permanent moot, because it's, you're gonna have a temporary moot for like 4 days or whatever. And then obviously with the temporary ban, it'll probably be a week if anything happens. But I'll tell you when you have been upset for mod, I'll tell you all of the essential like plugins and all that stuff that you guys need to put in. So that's that. Have I gone through everything? I don't think I've gone through everything. I'm not too sure. I actually don't know if I've gone through everything. Now, I'm just, you guys can have a look at all the plugins. I don't really care. But I'm just making sure I went through everything, man. I believe I've gone through everything that this server has to offer at the moment. And I actually, but you guys can do like slash trash if you want to get rid of stuff in your inventory as well. So that's that. But yeah, that's everything on the server at the moment. So now the server's released, guys. So if you want to join, the IP is on the screen as usual and in the description below, guys. What an episode. I don't know how long has this been actually been lasted for. If you guys want me to make a series of an admin factions where I play factions by an admin. So technically, I'm not a normal player, not like normal faction players. I'm just an admin testing things out on the factions realm, or just my server, guys. If you want that to be released where I'm playing factions, but as I'm playing factions, I'm banning people, watching people hacking and stuff like that. If you guys want me to do that type of series, then put like a comment in the description below, guys. And yeah, if you want to become a mod, then server, website and all that. Guys, thank you for watching, and I'm going to peace out now. So bye!